In this video, I will show you the assembly and use of the educational programming board and modules that I designed as open source. The motherboard is based on ESP Wi-Fi module and has 4-piece RJ25 jack ports. This allows the modules to be easily connected to the motherboard and used. In addition, the motherboard enables the control of dual motor and a servo motor. Finally, all the source codes in the project was created by the very popular ChatGPT recently, with amazing results. Let's get started. Printed circuit boards are preferred for long-term use, stable and more durable electronic circuit prototypes. I prefer PCBWay to turn my circuit designs into durable prototypes. Some surface mount device SMD components are preferred in this board. This affects the size and cost of the board design. For the assembly of SMD components, a stencil is generally preferred. Solder stencils help to accurately apply solder paste in position of components, and the stencil is usually ordered with the PCB. This process is simple. First, fix the printed circuit board and place the stencil to match the board. Then put some solder paste on the stencil with the help of a spoon and spread it with a spatula. After applying the solder paste, it is necessary to place the required components on the PCB. Where to place these components is usually indicated by a designator or footprint reference. These references are used as part of the PC design and ensure the correct placement of components. The designator shows what a component is and where it is located. Soldering is usually done with a hot plate machine or a hand soldering iron. The soldering machine heats and melts the solder paste and fixes the components in place. After the soldering is complete, the components are completely fixed in place when the solder paste has cooled. After soldering a few more components, the board will be complete. These components are a few headers and RJ25 jacks. It can be easily soldered with a soldering iron. The soldering of the motherboard is complete. At the next stage, there is the soldering process of the modules. The modules are a potentiometer, a humidity and temperature sensor, a buzzer, and an LED. It is possible to solder the modules with a soldering iron. You can see the locations of the components used in the modules in the shared designator. By the way, I mixed up the LED and buzzer module names, but the corrected and updated file has been shared with you. The assembly of the modules is complete. If you have any module add-on suggestions, please share them in the comments. In this part, grab a cup of coffee and take a closer look at what we can do with ChatGPT. It is a popular AI tool many of you probably know or are using. In the first step, I asked ChatGPT to generate a simple blink code for the LED and buzzer. Of course, I specified the pins to which the modules will be connected. The result is quite successful. I copied the generated code and pasted it in the editor. By the way, if you do not have ESP Wi-Fi set up, you will have to complete it by watching the previous project video. There is a simple thing to do while uploading the code. When you see the connecting notification, press the boot and reset buttons at the same time. Then release the reset and then the boot button. The upload will be completed in a few seconds. Let's plug the modules into the pins specified in the code and see the result. As you can see, both the motherboard, the modules, and the code are working properly. Now let's test the pot module and the servo motor. What I want from ChatGPT is to generate a code for servo motor control with a pot connected to its analog pin. The result is amazing. Added the servo library and used the map function, also added the Wi-Fi settings. Since we will not be communicating over Wi-Fi in this project, we are making the settings passive. Then we upload the code to the board. The result is successful again. The pot module and the servo are working successfully. The next module is a humidity and temperature sensor. I specified the pin that the module is connected to the board and also the library called DHT to use. I wanted it to generate a code that could display sensor values via serial monitor. As you can see, the result is again great. Let's upload the generated code to the board and see the values on the serial monitor. The humidity and temperature module also performs its function successfully. In the final step, let's try to generate code for a DC motor control. The 8833 driver is used for controls the DC motors, so I mentioned this in the question. Next, I defined the pins for the forward and backward motor movements. The driver contains sleep mode, and I have specified the pin it is connected to. Actually, the result is fine, but it may have messed up the sleep mode a bit. Perhaps I should add a little more detail to the question. I wrote the details of the sleep mode and also asked it to use pulse width modulation for the motor movements. This result is really great for DC motor control with pulse width modulation. It will only require a minor change over sleep mode. Only defining the sleep mode pin as high in the setup section will be sufficient for motor movement. I delete the sleep mode lines defined in the motor movement functions, and then the code is ready. Motor speed values can be defined optionally because pulse width modulation is used. There is the 1117.5-volt regulator on the motherboard, which makes it possible to supply it with an external power source. The motor movement LED indicators on the motherboard are working correctly, so the motor is running successfully. Thanks for watching. Like and subscribe for support.